pretty simple. You know, I told our guys rebounding and free throws was the effect of the outcome tonight. Got out rebounded and gave up 13 offensive rebounds. Obviously, we wanted to tip in and take the lead. It was a huge one as well. And then from the free throw line, you know, 12 for what we consider 22 because we missed a funny and a couple one-on-ones. So, you know, we left 10 points on the board. But, just gotta get better.
Did Denver do anything different, Coach, to get that? Or, you know, JJ said it was a lack of focus and edge, but, you know, why do you think that was? Or did Denver do something different that maybe you weren't prepared for?
No, I thought, you know, we gave them the right information. But just in general, regardless of if we didn't give them anything, rebounding was always huge. So, you know, at the end of the day, when you look at the stat sheet, and, you know, I think he's going to be a good player. But, you know, 37 minutes, Thompson to have one rebound, you know, that's a problem. Even Jake, two rebounds for 43 minutes. TJ, 32 minutes with one rebound. Morgan left the game as my second leader in rebounds. So it was more of a want by them at the end of the day. And we didn't do our job.
You mentioned the South Carolina game. You thought that was probably your best defensive effort for the whole game. And you come out and perform like that tonight. What's the issues and the consistency there from game to game?
At the end of the day, you know, you lose Maldonado, so that's one of your experienced guys. Obviously down the body with nine. So, you know, you're relying on TJ as a freshman and AJ as a first-year player, and obviously Brandon and Tariq. But, you know, it's just, like I told him, it's tough sometimes when you're communicating something in timeouts, whether it be on the board or just verbally communicating it, and we go out there and we don't execute. I thought South Carolina was one of our better, smarter efforts, but again, we played a lot of zone. Tonight we played more man because of their ability to shoot the three ball. Guys had to play a lot of minutes. You know, JJ didn't come off the floor. Probably wasn't one of his best performances as well, offensively or defensively, or even rebounding the basketball. And he led us with eight. So,
was it really surprising? I mean, you guys have been kind of undermanned and outsized by teams, but still battled on the glass. I mean, how surprising was it that you didn't see that battle in that fight tonight?
At the end of the day, I mean, even for me, I even got emotional there a little bit, seeing Maldonado. He's our captain, he's our leader, one of our leaders. Seeing him go down and in the pain that he was in, affected me because I know how hard he competes. You know, already wants to be out there. You know, what he's done to get back out there. You know, it's disheartening. But, you know, I mean, the rebounding and the free throws, but in the same breath, you know, with all that happening, you know, you still have an opportunity to win the basketball.
I mean, Maldo went down as soon as it's his back, and do you have any kind of early report on what might be going on there?
I went in the locker room right before I went down the radio just to check on him. And, it doesn't look good. You know, he's teared up a little bit, red eyes. I know how passionate the kid is. Everybody walked in the team just to check on him. But I have not talked to Dallas or the doctors yet to see what's going on.
Alan, you've coached as an assistant head coach for a lot of years. It's just the way that the beginning of the season transpired with all the injuries, the suspension. I mean, has this been maybe your most challenging year as a coach?
Man, test your faith, man. It has been. And it's some of them you can't control, you know, at the end of the day. But, you know, I believe in what we're doing and how we're going about it. I believe I come to practice every day with positive energy. I think our guys do the same. I think even as coaches, we try to teach them more than just a game of basketball. You know, we have coaching classes. We try to get out into the community. Like we have a program here, but all these things on top of one another, it's tough. And, you know, I'm not the one to sit up and blame it on anything or try to make excuses for it, but they are facts. You know, it hurts with, you know, what you're trying to do. Obviously, Denver had been going through some of that as well, and recently, I guess, got back healthy enough. But yeah, I would say the most challenging. Whether head coach or assistant, I've never been around this much injuries, even a suspension, which, you know, at the end of the day, you're talking about key components to what we're trying to do. So you have to consistently adjust things to go forward. But like I said, I mean, I think we got a good group of guys, and you know the locker room is hurt right now. But there's more basketball to be played.
I mean, you got 9 or 10 days before your next game, and I know there'll be rest, there'll be finals, you know, there'll be practice. With everything you've gone through, could have some time like this, at least between games, come at a better time for you right now?
Was kind of a double-edged sword because you don't want to sit on a loss this long. But you know, you try to learn as much as you can from it. You know, Notton got cleared to work his way back in, so that's a positive note. You know, with these 10 days, maybe possibly. Ready for the Texas trip, if not Dixie, for sure. But, you know, as soon as I find out about Maldonado, I'm sure that's going to need some rest just for his body, but also his mental at the same time. You know, JJ, rest, Jake, rest. And, you know, we still got to get some of the newer guys more ready to play basketball. Right now, I mean, it's just a lot of mental mistakes, even for the new ones that was out there. But you kind of have to go with what you have right now. That's what you have. So, you know, I don't think, you know, I mean, I know my voice sounds a little down, but that's more so for the loss. But there's not any discouragement within our guys, or within our staff, even within communicating to our guys. We just got to regroup and put our best foot forward as, you know, we get prepared for conference season.
So for Jordan, what is he cleared for full contact?
He's not clear. Well, he's not cleared for full contact. He's cleared to now work his way back up to full contact. So he's running, got in on shooting around today, did some dummy offense. We do a segment post guard split, so he got in there and pretty much got an individual in. So that timetable was more so on him and Dallas, in the sense of bringing him back to contact, but probably will go through some pads first before he goes to contact.